Rıvan, my name is Başaruzan Tekçe. I will talk about our project. Project objective. Create a tool for teachers which is easy, simple and fast. It facilitates keeping all the records of the students, such as their TC, name, surname, date of birth, email, phone number, etc. The system also keeps the records of the teachers as well with their TC, name, surname and date of birth. All of the information about a student or a teacher will be available in a very short time. The system also keeps lesson, class, action and action grades informations. We made this system with the objective of keeping this information. In addition, another objective of us is to help teachers and high school administrations. Why people need the student record system? Every year, thousands of students go to school and they take different exams, do homework, take attendance, and determine which teacher will enter which class or which students will enter which class. In addition, the information of teachers, students, and parents should be in the hands of the school for any situation. In this case, things can get a little confusing. This situation leads us that we need to keep track of these people in the school. I mean, that is to record their information. This information is constantly changing. For example, a new student or teacher may come to the school, or someone may go, or for instance, exam dates will be determined. In such case, easy addition and subtraction is only possible with a good program. With our program that we have developed, we find solution to all these problems. Main purpose of the project. Without the student record system, it would be hard to manage with the details for a school. So, the main purpose of this student record system project is managing and recording all of detailed personal data of students and teachers efficiently. We try to use a simple and functional structure as much as possible. Although the primary purpose of the system is to keep student information, the system allows creating new new classes, lessons, and exams. We also aim that the user can keep teacher information. It is also one of the aims of this project that the user can quickly add and delete these informations. The problems solved by student record system. View all teachers. Add a new lesson. Delete a lesson. View all lessons. Add a new class. Delete a class. View grades of students in a class. View all exams. View the highest grades in exams. Add a new exam. Delete a exam. Grade a exam. Add a new student. Delete a student. Search a student. Edit a student. View all students. Add a new teacher. Delete a teacher. Which users have access to the system? Teachers can access the system and make change about students, classes, lessons, grades, and exams easily. How a user can access it? After logging into the system, they can easily access the database indirectly through the interface. How did we develop our program? We used MySQL and Database analysis. We used research and interviewing technique to build this project. We have looked into similar project on internet. We examined the student registration forms of some schools and create a data list. By focusing on the common points in them, then we create a sample data and create UNF table. Then we used UNF table to create the ER diagram and the tree NF table by applying the normalization rules.
Hello everyone. My name is Büşra. I am going to talk about the entity relationship diagram. ER diagram will help us understand the relationship between tables better and easier. Firstly, as you can see, there is a difference between our first ER diagram and final ER diagram. Because after we made the first version, we made change and added the university table. Also, we added graduated from and emergency contact methods. After that, as you can see, we have 8 tables. These tables keep information about student, teacher, class, parent, lesson, exam, grade, bullet type, university from which teacher graduated and middle school from which student graduated. When we look at the student-teacher relationship, there is a many-to-many relationship because each student has more than one teacher and each teacher has more than one student. This is also true between student and lesson relationship. However, it is not same for student-parent, student-middle school or student-bullet type relationship. Because each parent or each bullet type is for one student. These data are primary case. Our other primary case are student ID, class ID, bullet type, teacher ID, lesson ID, parent ID, middle school ID. We also have foreign case. These are teacher bullet type ID, parent ID, class ID, middle school ID, bullet type ID, class teacher ID, lesson ID, etc. Thanks to these foreign keys, we can prevent possible data duplication and be prepared for any future updates. Difference between first and final ER diagram. After the first report of the system, our customer reviewed the system and decided they would like to expand some of the students and teacher information. The customer wanted an emergency contact number for a student, and also they wanted to know what university a teacher graduated from. So, we improved our system by adding graduated from as foreign key and emergency contact information. Now, let's talk about normalization. As you can see, there is a long table here. It is so long that I couldn't fit on the page. This is the first table we made. Quite confused and disorganized. For this, we made a table again, and this table is one click better than the other. But unfortunately, that is not good enough either, and it is still irregular table. If we pass the second normalization form, we will be able to see a more regular and meaningful table. There are enumeration instead of long repetition. Class ID, bulletin ID, lesson ID, exam ID. When we pass the third form, which is the last stage, the simplest and most organized table awaits us. As you can see, we have obtained the simplest form of our table with class ID, student ID, exam ID, grade ID, etc., which we encode with numbers only. Our last table with the same function as the first table, but completely different in appearance. Simplifying the tables by advancing in this way allows us to understand the relationship, and we can find the answer to the question of how we can do what we want to do more easily. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Minisu. I'm going to be talking about the features of our project that our customer wanted. In our first feature, our customer wanted to be able to list the students in a class and their grades. To do that, we select the data that we want to list, such as student ID and grade and lesson name. We select these data from the tables. After the selection, we set class letter and the class number variables and match them. After the first match, we match the other keys of the tables, such as class ID and student ID. And as we can see in this screenshot, when we choose the class number 12 and the class letter as A and press the show button, for instance, we can see that the student ID 100 got the grade 90 in math exam. For our second feature, we list the exams and the students on each exam with the highest score. To do that listing, we select the data that we want to list, such as exam ID and grade ID, from their tables. And then we match the keys of the tables, as we can see in this part. And after the matching, we sort the rows by the order of the exam ID. And here we can see its example. We are sorting the rows with exam ID starting from 1 to 7. And we can see in every exam there is the highest score of the exam. And we can also see the student ID who took that highest score. And for our third feature, the customer wanted to be able to change the teacher for a lesson. To do that feature, we change the lesson and teachers table. We are updating that table and set the new teacher's name and the surname after we choose the lesson name and the lesson level. For instance, in here, we want to choose the math lesson with lesson level 12. In the old data, the teacher who is assigned for this lesson is Hasan Gül, and we want to change that into Nurida. To be able to do that change, we select Nurida and we select the ID and press the change teacher button. And then, as we can see here, now The math lesson with the 12th lesson level is now assigned to Nurida. For our fourth feature, we add a new student to the system. To add a new student, we create a temporary table, which is called temp student table. After we create the temporary table, we assigned the datas, all the datas of a student, of a new student, to that table. After the first insertion into the temp student table, we assign its parents' data into the parent table. We insert these data, these three data, into the parent table. And then after that insertion, we start to insert the middle school data of the new student and insert it into the middle school table. And lastly, we insert the temporary student tables data to the student tables. We match its keys one by one. And after that insertion, we delete the temporary student table. So now we have a new student. As you can see in this screenshot, this is the new student adding screen. We enter all the data and then press the add new student button and we create a new student. And our last feature is removing an exam from the system. We choose the exam that we want to delete from the exam table by the exam ID key, as we can see here. After we choose the exam that we want to remove, we delete the grades assigned to that exam as well. And we delete these grades by using these commands, as you can see. And here in the screen, if we want to remove an exam, we choose the exam and press the remove button, and our exam will be deleted as well as its grades which were assigned to that exam. And these are all of our features. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Arda, and now I will give a short demonstration about how our system works on user interface. As we said before, we developed this system for the teachers. So first of all, they must be logging into our system with their ID, teacher ID and passwords. After the logging into the system, we are faced with a new window. We have three options in here. These are the add option, view, edit, remove option and others option. Add and view, edit, remove options. We will use these two options to implement basic operations such as insert, select, delete and update in our database system. On the other end, we have others section. In this section, we will see the dynamic results of some predefined queries. So, first, let's talk about the, if you want to see a list of a student or list of a something else, you can simply click the view section and then select one of these you want to see its information. For example, let's select the teacher button. And as you can see, all teachers who are recorded to our system are listed in here. You can see the information about them, like their TC numbers, their email addresses, or universities they graduated from. In the same way, you can see the class information or lesson list, exam list, and of course student list. There are four students are recorded in our system for now, as you can see. Also, you can search the students. Let's click the search button. And for example, let's see the students who are in the 12A class. I click the find button, and as you can see, there are three students in the 12A class. And also you can use the other conditions to search some specific type students. Then you can click the reset table and all students are come back again. Okay, now let's add a new student to our system. To add operations, you can simply select the add section, then click the student. As you can see, a new page is appearing. After the filling the blanks with appropriate values, then click the add new student. You can easily add a new student to our system. I will do it for an example. I will give a random values. This can be and click the add new student. Then let's check. As you can see, our new student is added the system successfully. In the same way, you can add a new teacher, class, lesson, or exam. So let's see how we can change the teacher of a lesson. For this, we come to view edit remove again. Then I select the lesson. Then you can select the course we want to change from the list. For example, I can select this. Then I choose a teacher to change it with the previous one. Let's say this guy. And as you can see, this guy is the new teacher of this lesson. In addition, we can remove the information that we think is not useful anymore. To do that, choose what you want to remove, click the remove button, and that's it. Let's do that. For example, this lesson. Click the remove button, and it's gone. Or let's do that for the exam section. Click remove and it's gone. Okay, after these basic operations, let's look at other functions. There are two views here. The first one allows us to see the students' grades in a class of our choosing. For example, let's choose the 12A class and click the show button. As you can see, all grades of the students that are in this class is listed in here. That's another class. As you can see, one grade from one student in this class. And finally, with the second view, teachers can easily track the highest grade for each exam and who got it. Our user interface actually supports many other features. For example, adding students to the courses or enter exam grades. But basically, this is how our system works. That's all we have to say. Thank you for watching, guys.